Hello, I'm Jan-Heinrich Reimer, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to the presentation of our work, Axiomatic Retrieval Experimentation with IR Axioms. This work was done together with my colleagues, all presented on this slide. First of all, let me briefly introduce axiomatic thinking in information retrieval. IR axioms are formally defined constraints that describe properties of successful retrieval scoring functions. If we consider the BM25 ranking function shown at the bottom of this slide, we can narrow down its three main properties: a term frequency rating, highlighted in yellow, an inverse document frequency rating, highlighted in orange, and a length normalization, highlighted in green. Let us now focus just on the term frequency rating. One of the early proposed axioms, TFC1, considers term frequency counts and suggests to favor documents that contain more query terms. The axiom is originally formulated as follows. For simplicity, we have a query that consists of one single term and a pair of documents with the same length. If a document 1 contains more query terms than document 2, it should be placed higher in the ranking. At the example documents shown on the lower half of this slide, we can see that the query term, highlighted in yellow, occurs 2 times in document 1, but only 1 time in document 2. Thus, the TFC1 axiom would yield a preference towards document 1. Simple, isn't it? Because retrieval axioms can give explainable insights on retrieval models, in the past, axioms have been applied to improve initial retrieval results by axiomatic re-ranking, to regularize a loss function in neural models, or for combining ranking scores from different models. Neural rankers are often treated like black box retrieval models, like shown on the lower half of this slide. Recently, axiom preferences have also been used to analyze and explain ranking decisions of such neural rankers. Even though many great software frameworks have been developed that allow easy implementation and evaluation of retrieval pipelines, none of the existing frameworks includes components for retrieval axioms. To close this gap, we present IR Axioms, a Python framework for easy experimentation with IR axioms, in which we implemented 25 existing axioms. We call our TFC1 example. With artificial preconditions like requiring strictly the same document length, the axiom is rarely applicable in practice. Thus, in our implementation, we relax such preconditions, allowing a length difference of up to 10% and considering multi-term queries. IR axioms is also tightly integrated with PyTerrier and IR datasets, providing an easy access to the retrieval models and test collections there. IR axioms is extensible so that you can easily implement your own customized axioms as Python classes. In the example at the bottom of this slide, we can see an implementation of the aforementioned TFC1 axiom, in which we define an axiom name and overload the preference function. In the preference function, we first check if the two documents have approximately the same length. Then we count term occurrences for all query terms. If the term frequencies are different enough, we prefer the document with the higher term frequency. We have now prepared some examples of how IR axioms can be used with example data from the MS Marco dataset and tracked deep learning topics. To prepare our experiments, we first need to initialize PyTerrier, download the MS Marco dataset, and index passages from the dataset. We can then define baseline rankers to compare in our analyses, in this case BM25 and PL2. For postdoc axiomatic analyses, we create an axiomatic experiment by specifying the rankers, axioms, depth, topics and QLs, index and document dataset. Let's first compute a data frame of all axiomatic preferences up to the specified depth. Computing preferences can take a while depending on the number of rankers, topics, axioms, and depth. This data frame contains the document pairs in rows and preferences of all axioms in separate columns. Here, a preference of 0 means that the axiom has no preference. 1 means that the original order should be preserved, and -1 means that the documents should be swapped. The data frame also includes the original ranking preference, called orig, and the preference induced by relevance judgments, called oracle. We can select columns from the data frame to focus on just some of the axioms, for example, orig, oracle, and STMC1. Let us now compute the distribution of axiom preferences compared to the original ranking, that is, how many document pairs have a zero preference, or how often do axioms agree or disagree with the original ranking order. This table can be used to identify useful axioms which often disagree with the original ranking. For example, the STMC1 axiom here might often be violated because BM25 does not take semantic similarity into account. We can also find inconsistent pairs, that is, pairs where the original ranking contradicts the relevance judgments, and where at least one axiom could correct the mistake. As with the preference data frame, we select just some of the data frame columns. In this example, the original ranking violates the oracle preference, but the STMC1 axiom returns the correct preference. To debug a ranker, now it would be a good idea to look at the specific passages being compared. To improve a ranking's consistency with axioms, IR Axioms also features a PyTerrier module for axiomatic re-ranking. If we have multiple axioms, we would like to only change the original ranking order when a majority of the axiom agrees. In IR Axioms, we can combine axioms in a majority vote by using Python operators. The combination then itself becomes an axiom, and we can use that for re-ranking. For axiomatic re-ranking, IR Axioms uses the quicksort algorithm, which is similar to quicksort sorting. We first select a random pivot and then partition the ranking in documents that should be ranked higher or lower than the pivot document. Because re-ranking is implemented as a PyTerrier module, we can easily apply it to re-rank the top 10 results of our two baseline rankers. We now evaluate the re-rankers and the baseline rankers using PyTerrier's experiment helper, just as we would do with any other PyTerrier retrieval pipeline. Because we are using a combination of four axioms, the re-ranking might take some time. The results in this example indicate that re-ranking with a majority vote of multiple axioms often only slightly changes the system's effectiveness, but it improves the consistency with axioms and makes the retrieval system more explainable. As I have shown, it is easy to use IR axioms to analyze retrieval models or to re-rank initial retrieval results. But of course, IR axioms has so much more to offer. Our built-in evaluation tools can analyze a ranking's consistency with 25 reference axioms and show examples that help you build a better ranking model. Furthermore, IR Axioms supports axiomatic re-ranking with quicksort and can generate features for learning to rank. With built-in caching and parallelization, we can speed up the computation of axiom preferences. IR Axioms is free and open source software, and we gratefully accept contributions on GitHub. We invite you to install our Python package and try out IR Axioms today. Thank you very much for listening, and a big thanks to the SIGIR for giving me a student travel grant.